everyone, it's Lauren, and today I'm planning a little party. Nope, not a birthday party. Let's go to the beach. Yeah, no, not a beach party.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
I give up. Nope, not a Christmas party. I'm talking about a back to school party. So I know that we're all enjoying our summer, but I'm actually pretty excited for this upcoming school year. One of my favorite things to do would be buy school supplies. One thing that I noticed was that all of the cute school supplies are expensive, and that's just like breaks my heart because then I'm left with boring yellow pencils.
I thought what we had was special.
So that's why I decided to come up with a few projects to help you spice up your school supply. You're all invited to join the party, and let's go. So first up would be DIY pencils. You'll need pencils, a paintbrush, Mod Podge, scissors, and magazine papers. And once you pick out your pattern, you're going to want to set your pencil down onto the paper and measure it, and then cut out enough to fit all around the pencil. Next, set your pencil next to the piece of paper and make sure that it fits. Now, using our lovely Mod Podge, we are going to open that up and take our paintbrush, and then we're going to apply an even coat of the Mod Podge onto the pencil, making sure that you don't leave any spaces out and that there's enough so that the magazine will stick. And then go ahead and place the magazine paper onto the pencil and stick it down, making sure there's no air bubbles. Now, once you wrap the whole pencil with your magazine, go ahead and cut the excess off, leaving a little bit of overlap. Now, taking your paintbrush, you're going to want to use the Mod Podge and put it where that overlap is, because we will be sealing that down. Now, once you've finished applying Mod Podge to the seam, just go ahead and smooth it out with your fingers, and it's okay if extra gets on because we are taking our Mod Podge again and placing it all over the magazine paper just to seal it and make sure that everything stays. Once you finish coating, go ahead and set it aside to dry, and then you could make more like I'm doing right here. I'm using all kinds of different magazine papers, but you could also use wrapping paper. That's fun. So that's it. Our next DIY is the glitter one. You'll need Mod Podge, glitter, a skewer, a pencil, and a paintbrush. Now, taking our Mod Podge, we're going to use the paintbrush and we're going to just paint the metal part of the pencil, making sure not to leave any parts out because we want the whole thing covered with glitter. And then using your glitter, just dump it out. And what we're going to do is we're just going to roll the Mod Podge part into the glitter to coat it. And once you're satisfied with your glitter, you're just gonna wipe off the excess, and then you can use the skewer to wipe off the parts that are stuck in the little crevices, and you're finished. Our next pencil involves glue, rhinestones, and other embellishments if you want, skewers, mechanical pencils, and a piece of paper. Now, taking your glue, go ahead and squeeze that out onto the piece of paper or whatever you have handy. And then you're going to take your skewer and dip it in the glue and put it onto the little paperclip part of your pencil. And then I'm just going to take one of my rhinestones and stick it on, making sure that it's secure and in the glue. And then just press it on for a little bit and go ahead and put your other rhinestones on. And lastly, I'm just going to put one of these little flowers because I think it would be cute and it would finish off the design well. And then you can also make other designs. Like, you don't have to do what I do. You can pick pink rhinestones or blue rhinestones or even two flowers like I'm doing here. I think these pencils are really cute, and I think that people will be less likely to steal your pencils if they know that you made them. So yeah, just saying. And next we have our no-so pencil case. Woo! Now you'll be needing some duct tape, something to measure with, some scissors, some fabric, and a stapler. And you'll also be needing a zipper that's longer than 10 inches. Now, for the first step, you just want to unfold your fabric and measure out 6 inches. And then mark that with your scissors. And then measure out 10 inches. And then just cut it out to make a 6 by 10 inch rectangle. And you'll actually be needing 2 of these. So once you finish cutting that out, take your first rectangle and use that as a pattern for the second rectangle so that they're exactly the same size. And once you cut out both triangles, you're gonna have you know what I mean. And take your duct tape and cut out a piece that's as long as the rectangle. I got it right that time. And then just go ahead and put that on the top and then smooth it down. And we're just gonna cover the whole back of the fabric with this duct tape. And then go ahead and cut off the excess duct tape so there's no sticky parts. Now just make sure to do that to both pieces of fabric and then just flip them over, and this is an optional step, but I'm going to take some gold duct tape and put it on the front to create create sort of a color block design, and I'm just pressing that down making sure there's no air bubbles, and I'm doing the same to the other one, and just make sure that if you're doing this to line up the second piece of duct tape because you don't want it to be uneven. And then just cut off the excess like we've been doing. Now taking your stapler and your zipper, you're just gonna wanna unzip your zipper halfway and place it face down on one of the fabric pieces, and then just start stapling down. And then once you get towards the zipper head, you're going to want to flip it up a little bit. Wait, hold on, almost. Okay, here, and then you're going to zip it up just to get it out of your way, and then continue stapling down the side of your zipper. And now your zipper should be placed onto your fabric. Now taking your other fabric, we're gonna lay the zipper down kind of the exact same way, but now it's attached to the other fabric, so just position it how you did before. And we're just gonna place it down and remember to unzip it halfway again. And then just line it up, making sure it's straight because we don't want a crooked zipper. And then just staple it down. Now move that zipper head out of the way. We don't need you. Yes, we do actually. But just go ahead and finish stapling down your zipper. And once you're finished, you're gonna wanna open up your pencil case and close the zipper, and it should look kinda like a butterfly. And okay, actually we're gonna unzip it again. And then we're gonna take our stapler and staple all down the sides and the bottom to make our pencil case. So this is what you measure. Then cut off the extra so there's not too much material, and then take some duct tape to cover up those staples because we do not want a boo-boo when we're reaching for a pencil. Now, once you seal in those bad boys, what you're gonna wanna do is open up the rest of your zipper and turn your pencil case right side out so we can see the beauty that you made. And then taking your scissors, you're just gonna want to push the corners out a little more to make it look more like a corner than a curve. And then you're ready to go to school. You're forgetting your pencils. Yeah, I'm right. After all that work, you do not want to forget your pencils in your pencil case, so make sure to put that in your backpack, and then you're ready to go. So I hope you guys liked this video. I loved making it, and it was so much fun. Make sure to let me know in the comments if you want me to do any more of these tutorials, maybe a notebook or a binder or something like that. And then make sure to subscribe to me and like this video, and check out my other social media so that we can, like, you know, chat or whatever, and send me pictures, tag me on Instagram, and I love you guys. See you next Monday. Bye!